keep on trying
to keep away from dying.
Honey Zoomers NYC. Was that harmony?
C'è la luna, mezza mare, mamma mia, mia mare. Figlia mia, cutterara, mamma mia, pesaccio tu. Se ti doni alla musicante, io ti vai, io ti vieni, sembra lo strumento una mano di. Se ci piglia vanno sì, lo strumento, figlia mia. Oh mamma, zumba, zumba, baccola. Oh mamma, zumba, zumba, baccola. Oh mamma, zumba, zumba, baccola.
Elena, hi, how are you?
Deborah, my beautiful niece.
Oh, Aunt Lee, it's so good to see you.
It's good to be seen.
So you figured out how to use the computer, huh?
I had no choice, or else I couldn't see that beautiful face of yours. Ooh, the face. You look just like your mother when she was your age.
Oh, Aunt Lee, come on, stop. You're making me blush. Listen, do you need anything? Anything at all? I'll just run it over. I'll leave it right by your door.
Young Marlon Brando I need. And then, I don't care if I never leave the house again.
Well, I'll start working on that for you. But I'm serious. Please, tell me. Food? Anything?
Hey, food. I got enough food in here to last me till kingdom come. You want a tray of big ziti?
Oof. I just might take you up on that.
It's here. All we gotta do is throw it in the oven, 350 for a half hour.
Are you doing it right, huh? Or are you getting bored?
Bored? I go out 4 times a day.
Where do you go?
I do my walks. I go to the supermarket. I go get my mail.
Aunt Lee, you're a social butterfly even during a lockdown.
Lockdown? I got ants in my pants. Ants. Gonna ants. Where is my favorite handsome nephew? Anthony, you, where are you, sweetheart? It's your favorite godmother who loves you.
Talk to her.
Tell her I'm not here.
And where could you be?
Tell her I'm in the shower.
Aunt Lena, he's in the shower.
That's good. He throws himself in there right when he gets home.
Driving that bus all day. Ooh,
I think about him. I pray for him. I'd light a candle if that friggin' church was open.
He's so brave. I tell all my friends that my nephew, my godson, is an essential worker. I'm so proud of him. You have no idea. The doctors, the nurses, the firemen, the people at the grocery, they all get to work because of my Anthony, my courageous nephew, my hero.
Yeah, he's in the shower.
How's mommy?
She's okay. You know, some days good and some days bad. And sometimes I call her and she's a little stunned.
She's sharp as a tack when I call her. At first, she gives me that crazy act. And then I give her one yell. Marie, it's your sister. Stop that shit. I don't vote for that. Who is this bullshit?
Well, she's got dementia, Aunt Lee.
My ass she's got. After she gets the yell, she straightens right up. She remembers everybody and everything.
Look, Deb.
Maybe this is not my place, but I'm your aunt, this is my sister, and I gotta speak my piece. You and your brother have gotta put your heads together on this. You gotta get her out of that place. It's one thing to put her in a nursing home, I understand. Use work. She couldn't live alone no more, she couldn't take care of herself. But it's a whole other thing to keep her there, especially now. There's sitting ducks in those places. She's gotta come out.
Aunt Lee, you know...
Don't mean Lee me. I love yous like you were my own kids. Like you came out of my own bukya. But I'm telling you plain now, she's gotta come out.
This is Anthony's house, you know. I'm just a guest here.
I know. You got a raw deal because of that friggin' Chester the molester. I'm sorry. I know life throws you things.
But this is your mother we're talking about now. I look at, you know, old pictures of me and her from years ago. And I cry my eyes out, thinking, what happened to her? My older sister. God in heaven. You two have got to get her out of there. Or else I'm going to rent a van and I'm going to break her out. And I don't even drive. Huh?
Don't get upset, Aunt Lee, all right? I'm going to talk to Anthony.
Don't talk too long. They're dropping like flies in those places. I love your mother. I can't see her in there.
I know.
I love you.
Love you.
Oh my God, son, to call me back.
I will. I will.
He fills my heart with pride, that one.
Yeah, me too.
And then.
What?
You gotta get her out. Well, God forbid. You might never see her again.
No. Catch it.
But don't catch nothing else. I love you.
Love you. Love you. She's right, you know?
Right about what?
About Mommy. We gotta get her out of that place.
Well, what are we gonna do with her?
Oh, we gotta take her out.
And put her where?
Here.
Here? Where here?
Here. Here. Listen, give her the bedroom. I'll stay on the sofa. I'll stay on the floor, and I don't care. We just gotta get her out of there, all right?
I don't know.
You don't know what? You don't know.
I mean, I don't know if it's the best idea.
The best idea for who?
The best idea for her. I'm only thinking of her. She's in that, you know, vulnerable population. You can't just move her into the house. You don't know what we have.
Oh, come on, Aunt. Come on. What do we have? Really, what do we have? You haven't seen the street in, what, 7 weeks? And where do I go? I go to the grocery store, I come back. I'm all covered up like the mummy.
I don't know.
Stop saying you don't know, Aunt. Now, do you want to hear or not? You don't want her here, do you?
She's my mother. I want to do what's right for her, what's right for everybody. I'm just listening to the medical experts.
Yeah, okay, but you want to do what's right for you first, right?
Cuomo ain't even seen Matilda.
Oh, Aunt, listen. If we leave her in there, she could die.
And if we bring her here, we could... I just don't know what to do, Deb, all right? I just don't know.
All right, you don't know? Good, good. So let me decide, okay? This is our mother we're talking about, Aunt. Our mother, you know, the woman who, when we were sick as kids, used to let us cough into her mouth so we would think she caught it from us and we didn't have it anymore.
And what science was that based on?
No, no, it wasn't. It wasn't. It was based on heart. You understand? Sometimes you gotta do what's right based on what you feel in your heart.
I don't know what to feel anymore.
Why don't you try feeling, period? Why don't you try that for a change?
What do you mean by that?
You're so wrapped up with your own shit and anxieties and your phobias that you can't even take 1 second to think about anybody else but yourself.
Debbie, I don't want anybody in my house that can get me sick, okay?
This is your mother.
Anybody.
I can't believe what I'm hearing. Really, I cannot believe the things you're saying.
Because if I get sick, I'm telling you right now, if I get sick, I'm gonna fucking kill somebody.
You know what, Aunt? You're right. You're right when you say you're not well. You're not well up here. You're sick. You're sick in the head. Your own mother, Aunt. Your own mother.
You don't understand.
Oh, no, no, I do understand. You're a big killer, right? You're a big killer. You want to kill people. So then go ahead and kill people, Aunt. Kill people. Kill Mommy. Kill Aunt Lena. Why don't you kill me too while you're at it?
Debbie, please. You don't understand.
No, kill me. You want to kill somebody? Kill me. Come on, start here, Ed. All right? You're killing yourself with the way that you're living, the way you're thinking, the way you're behaving.
You think I want to feel this way?
You know what? I'll call Aunt Lena, all right? I got to do the dirty work all the time. I'll call her. I'll tell her, you said Mommy can't stay here. It's your house. You're the killer, so do what you want.
Debbie!
What?
Maybe she, Mommy,
Maybe Mommy could, maybe she could stay with Aunt Lena. All right, yeah, she's got the room. She lives alone. They get along. You know, they're company for each other, Mommy and her. So maybe they could do that, you know?
Okay.
Okay?
Okay, I'll ask her.
Okay.
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 Hey, Aunt Lee. Yeah, it's me. Alright, so I spoke to Aunt. And, he was thinking. We were thinking. That, you know, maybe Mommy would like the idea of moving in with you.